Let's start with the big news this morning, and let's start with what's happening in Ukraine. So overnight, we've got news, major news out of Ukraine, as President Zelensky now calling on the rest of the world, now calling on the European Union, please help, please wake up, because our nuclear sites are under attack. And the Russians are attacking our nuclear sites. There's radiation leaking all over the place. And we are heading into a holocaust of nuclear proportions.
Well,
it turns
fact,
out it's not the case at all, actually.
Well, they are warning that it could be a Chernobyl-like situation. But the Wall Street Journal and the Associated Press and Reuters all confirmed that no nuclear radiation has escaped. In fact, the fire it hit a training facility near the plant, but none of the six reactors themselves. In fact, they're saying that a ceasefire was supposed to be discussed in the same day we're going to discuss.
Європа зараз повинна прокинутися.
Okay.
Горить найбільша атомна станція Європи. Прямо зараз російські танки розстрілюють атомні блоки. Це танки, обладнані тепловізорами. Тобто вони знають, куди стріляють. Вони до цього готувались. Звертаюся до всіх українців, до всіх європейців, до всіх людей, хто знає слово Чорнобиль, хто знає, скільки горі жертв приніс вибух на атомній станції. Це була глобальна катастрофа. З її наслідками боролися сотні тисяч людей, евакуювали десятки тисяч людей. Росія хоче це повторити і вже повторює, але у 6 разів більше. Європейці, прокиньтесь, будь ласка, говоріть своїм політикам.
So I love that, of course, he's reading off of something there, which is to try to get the EU to come in and help us right now, to wake up and to help us as quickly as you can, because we are under direct nuclear threat from Russians. Again, this is not true. This did not happen. Ukrainian leaders once again lying, and the difference on the ground is, you know, the difference between what they're saying publicly and what is actually happening is there's a huge difference, right? Last night, a fire broke out at that nuclear power facility. They have control over it, but the IAEA this morning specifically said, no, that was not damaged at all. The plant is fine. That was a training facility next door where there were some flares that caught fire that like landed, but there was no leak of radiation, even though the Ukrainian government was saying this morning, yes, there's radiation leaking. Please, NATO, enact a no-fly zone over us right now. We need a no-fly zone over our country, which, of course, would lead to all-out war if that were the case.
Right. And well, so he's accusing Russia of, they didn't, even though he doesn't necessarily, he says our power plants are under attack because something was hit next to the power plants. But he is saying Russia intends to go even closer and actually hit those reactors. And they want to, right? I think at this point, the world understands that Chernobyl-like consequences don't stay contained in Chernobyl. Russia is close enough to know that a nuclear explosion would also affect its own country. So, you know, I don't think it's smart of any of us to assign intentions at this point.
Well, and I don't think Putin is actually that stupid, because he, you know, like, he know, like, they took over Chernobyl for a reason, like, because they want to make sure that that doesn't happen again. So it's like all of this hype, and it's like listening to that guy, it's like he's being, in my opinion, it feels like he's being coached by some U.S. person. You know what I mean? Like, there's this definitely has U.S. hands on it.
Well, I mean, I think he's an absolute puppet. I think that's the thing.
Yeah,
we've established
exactly.
Now that
I was going to compare it to like Guaido. He's like a Guaido that actually got in, that gave him power.
Well, and we saw yesterday from the French journalist who specifically spoke about Zelensky when she was asked, you know, well, what is she, and she covers Ukraine in Ukraine, and they're asking her specifically, you know, what's going on here? Is it, you're referring to Zelensky as a puppet? She's like, oh yeah, they're all corrupt. They are
right.
Corrupt. They are absolutely corrupt. So you're going to hear repeatedly again when the Ukrainian government tells us something. I'm not going to sit there and jump on Twitter and start changing my Twitter handle and changing my Twitter logo to be the Ukrainian flag right now. What they're telling us has been repeated lies over the past few days. Even the New York Times yesterday came out with a story about the Ukrainian misinformation. The New York Times, which loves war, is a warmongering newspaper, came out with this article, Fact and Mythmaking Blend. And that's a nice way of saying in Ukraine's information war. And they give the nice little examples of the ghost of Kiev and the Snake Island and stuff. They go into deeper examples in this New York Times piece. I mean, the New York Times of all companies calling out Ukraine's BS in this information
propaganda
campaign.
Or morale boosters, or perhaps both. So we're living in this sort of simulated reality where we all must just choose sides. And it's interesting, right, because most of us only consume Western media in our own language. The whole world is not with the Ukraine. I always love to say the Ukraine, please excuse me for throwing in the article. There are plenty of countries who are just willing to back Russia at this point. Look at Belarus, right, and suffering the consequences. Look at Armenia. There are plenty of other countries. And now it looks like China has said we are friends, but has not spoken much on this invasion in the last, 8-9 days, treading very lightly at this point.
Meanwhile, Vladimir Putin continues to say this morning that this is not war. This is a special operation to rid Ukraine of Nazis. Now, if you live in Russia, you this morning are not allowed to use the word war. You will be criminal. I mean, you will be arrested if you use the word war. You must call it a special operation. Putin said overnight that everything is going according to plan, and all indications are right now, this was his address last night, that all indications are that things are about to get much worse before they get better. So you have these dueling messages now coming out from Russia. So to be totally fair and open and transparent about this, I mean, Vladimir Putin saying, basically, we will arrest anyone. We will arrest anyone in Russia that uses the word war. This is a special operation. We're going in specifically, we're going to take over these cities. We will not stop until we oust the Nazis in the Ukraine.
Okay.
And if you use the term war, we will arrest you. We're also seeing journalists, we've seen state media, we've seen independent media shut down across Russia. We've seen social media shut down across Russia. So there's absolutely a propaganda campaign on the parts of the Russians, of course, to make sure that information is being limited inside of Russia. There's a lot of people in Russia who literally don't even know what's going on.
Mm-hmm. That sounds a lot like the U.S. with Corona, you know, like all the censorship and stuff that happened here.
Yeah, you're right. YouTube blocked, Twitter blocked, things blocked. Philip, go ahead. Sorry, I stepped on you.
I was going to say, to paraphrase what Grimm has been saying for the past couple of days, like, there ain't no saints in this war. And that's something we have to keep our eyes on is, like,
there are
no saints in this.
That's a good way to put it. Thank you for that analogy.
But I certainly don't want to be sitting there saying, hey, you know, Ukraine bad, Ukraine bad. Ukraine is corrupt. I mean, Ukraine is full of garbage right now. And the messages that Ukraine is putting out is garbage. But so is Russia. And what Vladimir Putin and what the police state in Russia is doing, arresting people who are speaking out against the military, who are holding protests against the military, who are calling it war, are being arrested, thrown in jail. We've certainly seen what he's done against Alexei Navalny, who's in prison for being the opposition.
Yes.
But the same
kind of like what we did
Ukraine.
To Snowden and Julian Assange, if they were here.
You guys, but there were ceasefire talks that happened yesterday, as promised. They didn't get very far, but there was an agreement for safe zones. Those are for evacuating civilians and delivering emergency supplies. So that's something, as long as everybody holds to them.
If you like this content, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Also, we have a membership program for the price of a cup of coffee once a month. You can support independent journalism just by going to morninginvest.com/join.
You get access to exclusive videos, plus the ability to join and chat with us live. We really appreciate your subscription, and you are supporting independent journalism.